mom called you to say that she will be home late tonight, and you have to cook food for your niece that you're currently babysitting. You decided to cook some vegetables, thinking that it is healthy for her. But, you suddenly realize that she does not like veggies. You want to try to persuade her, but how? Say no more to failed persuasion because 1961 existed. Two brilliant men named Mustafa Sharif and Carl Hovland did some brainstorming that led to the creation of the art of persuasion. Ta-da! The social judgment theory. As a persuadee or as a persuader, we all have a scale. We have our latitude of acceptance, where we put all our negotiables. These are the ideas, messages, and information that we are willing to agree or accept. On the opposite side, we have our latitude of rejection, where we disagree on ideas that are considered unreasonable. In the middle lies the latitude of non-commitment, where we neither accept nor reject the message. The main piece in this scale is the anchor. The anchor carries our attitude and our ego. Attitude is inside us, and it involves liking and disliking a person or a thing, while our ego weighs extreme opinions and things that we deeply care about. Our judgment occurs as we evaluate the message that we receive from other people, followed by shifting or adjusting our anchor, judge then adjust. Your niece hates vegetables, period. As a 5-year-old kid, all she could ever think about is to get away with a green leafy weird thing with a bitter aftertaste. Now, you want to persuade her to eat something healthy. Her latitude of acceptance tells us that she hates or dislikes vegetables, but she loves fruits and some sweets. Her latitude of rejection involves everything green and bitter. If you want her to eat vegetables, aim for the message that lies within her latitude of acceptance. Add some sweets in it or do something fun like making a milkshake out of veggies and fruits. When you try to push her on eating those greens, the outcome would be the opposite. She will hate it even more. The latitude of rejection extends while the space for the latitude of acceptance becomes further and less. It is also called the boomerang effect. You can also rely on her latitude of non-commitment. She doesn't like the bitter taste of vegetables, but if you say that it's because vegetables have nutrients that are good for the skin and helps kids to grow stronger, she may adjust her latitude of acceptance and try to eat the food you prepared for her. Finally, you and your niece were on the same page for a vigilant adventure. Therefore, in persuading someone, choose a message that falls near the edge of their latitude of acceptance. Persuading someone is like making food for people. This food could be the least favorite, the food they hate, the food that they never tried before, and the food that they love. To make them eat your food, you have to consider their preferences, to accept its taste, and say bon appetit. And if you cook food that does not include some of the things they like, they are most likely to reject or leave the food unfinished. Food satisfies your stomach, while persuasion places the conditions of their mind.